I'm Danielle Lyons. I work in Adam Bachstetter's lab as a postdoctoral scholar at the Spinal Cord and Brain Injury Research Center at the University of Kentucky. I grew up in Simpsonville, Kentucky, which is an hour from Lexington, so I'm homegrown Kentucky bred girl. When it was kind of a decision on where to go to college and graduate school, University of Kentucky was a no-brainer. My mom was an accountant for a while, and then she left and became a realtor, kind of while being a stay-at-home mom, so she's awesome. And then my dad works at the Toyota plant in Georgetown, Kentucky. I wanted to be everything, which is still kind of my problem. So anything that was trying to change the world, and I know that's very corny, but that's true. You can't always pinpoint it to like one person that determines, you know, what inspired you. But I think for me, like, it was all of these little steps that I just attribute to the Lord, like leading me to science. And he used many people to do that. I mean, there was a high school teacher that saw like my love for science, you know, in my junior year and just gave me this project and I kind of ran with it. And then when I was in college, I was working in two labs and I loved both. One was science and then one was psychology. So I didn't know what I wanted to do. Why I chose to actually become a scientist and study neuroscience was my mom. And she has a very distinctive disease called trigeminal neuropathic pain, trigeminal neuralgia, and there's not very good treatment for it. And that was kind of when I was like, you know what, I'm going to go in and I'm going to try to do something. And when you go in, you think you're going to like cure everything, but you realize like you can't do everything, but you can do a small part, and that small part can help someone else do a small part, and someone else do a small part, and then it just builds on each other. And that's the magic of science. I really like Adam. I really like working with him. I love the Spinal Cord and Brain Injury Center. That's actually one of the things I love most about science, because no day looks the same. So one day we'll be doing isolating microglial cells from mice, and we'll be looking at flow cytometry data, so like staining the cells. Another day we'll be doing MRIs, which is kind of where we're at right now, looking at different types of MRI sequences and collaborating with another lab to do that, along with the MRI spectroscopy core here, and determining like what can we measure after a traumatic brain injury. And so every day is just different. There is a moment, and you don't get it all the time, but when you find something out that no one else knows. And so for a split second, like, you are the only person in the world that knows that. And so that's just a revelation, and it's special. It's a special moment. We were just working on a project where we couldn't figure out this protocol, and you all kind of came in like right when we figured it out, and it's exciting. But like, you work, and you try really hard, and then if it doesn't work out exactly the way that I want it to work out, that's hard. So you have to handle defeat, and then you just have to persevere, knowing that one day it will. Okay, so the project that we're working on right now is, the whole lab is based upon looking at neuroinflammation after traumatic brain injury. So the one project that I'm really kind of interested in is actually what happens after a traumatic brain injury, and how can we look at that in MRIs? Using those different sequences, and so how can we measure cerebral blood flow? How can we measure astrocytic growth and the variscosities? How can you look at edema? And you can, and using MRIs and other confocal techniques, you can kind of look and determine what is happening, what time points are important, and then future, I mean, hopefully maybe some drugs can help those issues. Well, I love the University of Kentucky just in general. It's just home to me. I love that I feel like I can go into multiple people's labs and ask them for help on understanding a protocol or understanding a new area and understanding how to work a machine, and they'll help me. But I also like it because I feel like most of the people here, right? I can't speak for everybody, right? But most of the people here truly are doing it for the right reasons. And so that's encouraging.